I should have naturally thought of the boys' locker room first. Is that what you want to say? The victim was Chihiro, a girl. Hence why I said we should check the girls' locker room.
That does actually make a bit of sense. Not
bad, I'd say. On the contrary, there's something very strange.
Okay, then. Mm-hmm. What's so strange about it?
Oh, of course. Yeah. That one's, that one I was slow on. Didn't know it was Chihiro. It's a clear contradiction what Ryoka just said. I need to make it clear to everyone. New elements being added to non-stop debates. Corner. Next we're going to add something called a truth flashback. If you aim at the weak spot and hold down the left mouse button, then you'll memorize that weak spot. This memorized phrase can only be shot once with a single bullet. If you shoot or change the truth bullet, it'll disappear. Okay. Right, so
you said Byakuya was acting kinda weird before we found the body. But he was acting weird how?
If you're presented with the opportunity to check out the girls' locker room,
you absolutely take it! That's a
well, not everyone's like you.
Any guy.
No, just
the
a creep.
The victim was Chihiro, who was a girl.
Right.
So, of course, I would suggest we check the girls' locker room first. There was no time for pointless distractions. What's so strange about that?
I wish you'd taken me with you.
Fucking hell. Okay, so I know which one it is.
You said Byakuya, but he was acting...
If you're presented with the opportunity to check...
That's unnatural!
The victim was Chihiro.
No, that's wrong!
I'll tell you what's so strange about that, because up until we actually discovered the body, we couldn't have known who the victim was. So your claim that you went to the girls' locker room first because Chihiro was the victim doesn't hold up.
I see. That's a good answer, I must admit. Interesting. Very interesting indeed. But your reasoning is still too weak.
Huh?
What's wrong? Is that it? Surely you've got more than that. Go ahead. Show up.
What's wrong with Byakuya's attitude? It's like he doesn't even care. I've got him cornered, but he's acting like there's nothing to do with him.
You're not finished already, are you? There must be more to it.
This is why I kind of like him, because he's like, go on, play your little games, and then I'll be waiting here to finish it for you.
There is. I think. There is more to it. Think about it. We just talked about the differences between this case and past Genocide Jack incidents.
You look to the file.
The proof you're looking for is hidden in there.
Oh? Proof that I'm the culprit, you mean?
Differences between this case and the other Genocide Jack. Evidence proves... What kind of... What truth footage do we have? Hey?
What? The difference between the cases? You want me to explain it again? When I want to kill, I use my very own special scissors. And I use those same scissors to arrange the body.
But Chihiro was suspended with... It was some kind of rope, was it not?
That's right! It absolutely was!
Then there must be something very fishy indeed about that rope.
Hey, Byakuya, where'd you get it from, huh?
I'd never seen that rope before in my life. Obviously, somebody else must have had it hidden away somewhere.
Oh, I just... Okay, no, no, no. It is a truth bullet that we've got.
Chihiro, like it was some kind of rope.
That's right! It absolutely was!
Then there must be...
Hey, Byakuya, where'd you get it from, huh?
I'd never seen that rope before in my...
No, it's wrong!
You're full of shit! You bastard!
Actually,
I'm pretty sure you have seen it before. Because, you see, that rope, or should I say...
extension cord!
Extension cord? An extension cord?
We know the plug bit on it.
You use the extension cord in the library more than once, haven't you? And the same extension cord that was in the library all this time went missing after the murder. And there's no way someone who uses that extension cord as much as you do wouldn't discover that fact.
And Byakuya must be the one who took the extension cord. I can't imagine any other possibility.
That's really what you think? Then your conclusion is something like this. I killed Chihiro in the girls' locker room, then hung her up and wrote that bloody message.
Yeah, but there's something missing, which is... one, how'd you get there? Actually, no, because you knew about the logbooks. I'm just going to call them logbooks because I can't remember what they're called. The iPads is another word I could call it, but oh well. But you don't have the motive. That's the main thing. Motives are missing.
I intentionally made it look like Genocide Jack was behind it. Is that about right?
He's doing it again. He's totally calm, totally unconcerned. As if he's not really... he's not even involved. Wait,
what's wrong?
Not even involved.
I asked you if you think that's what happened.
Hell yes, that's what happened. So that's it, right? Byakuya is the killer.
I don't disagree with not disagreeing.
Kept calling this a game, right? So he'd be totally willing to do something like this to win.
Yeah. Oh, right, yeah. You got that, mate. I forgot about that.
Sorry, but could we hold on just a second? I think we need to talk about this a little more.
Sure. Do we really need to? We've already decided who did it.
I know, but still.
I know, but there's shut up.
It's still bothering me.
Is that right? And what, pray tell, is still bothering you? I killed her in the girls' locker room, then disguised my crime. Specifically, I dressed it up to make it look like it was the work of a homicidal psychopath.
Oh, because you can't go in. You can't go in, can you? Because I think if you go in, you get shut down.
What about all that bothers you?
Don't you get shot down if that happens? Hang on. No. Regulations, right. Students, move aside, yep. Nighttime, sleeping anywhere. No, we want something about... okay, maybe not. Wait, what was that just now? Something's not right. Byakuya's remark just now, that's something... what was Byakuya's remark? Oh, the scene of the crime.
You say you killed Chihiro in the girls' locker room, right? But are you sure about that? Isn't it possible that the murder took place somewhere else?
How disappointing.
The boy is
locker
room.
What kind of question is that? Even in the world of disappointments, this is a true letdown. She was found dead in the girls' locker room. There is absolutely no question about that. How could the scene of the crime have been anywhere else?
Well, I think it's entirely possible that she was killed somewhere else, then carried there later, along with the rest of the murder scene.
The rest of the murder scene? That was awfully specific. Please tell me you have a reason for saying all of that.
What the fuck are you on about now? Hey, Byakuya, did I just take you off guard? And the story suddenly moved to the crime scene. Byakuya, who's been so confident until now, maybe Byakuya never even realized that the actual scene of the crime could have been somewhere
don't
else.
Just move on without permission? What do you mean she was killed somewhere else?
Come on, Makoto. If there's any chance the murder took place somewhere else, let's see the proof.
The map, Sakura's account, and the posters. Let's do that one first.
I got it! The proof that she was killed somewhere else is the poster that's hanging in each locker room.
Your proof is some posters?
The poster in the girls' locker room was
of a busty lady.
Of a big boobed supermodel. But don't you think that's kind of strange?
Let's see Phoebe's reaction.
Why would the girls' locker room have a poster like that?
I bet those massive jugs of hers were totally fake!
Meanwhile, the boys' locker room had
moving on.
A poster of the super popular boy band Tornado. Again, that doesn't really seem to belong in a boys' locker room.
Well, not if it's not defaced. I mean, if there was a One Direction thing in the boys, it would probably be like them doing each other up the arse or something like that.
So you're saying that maybe the posters were switched?
And there's one other thing I noticed about the locker rooms. You know what I'm talking about, right, Sakura?
You're referring to my protein coffee, aren't you?
Protein coffee?
While I was in the girls' locker room earlier, I spilled some protein coffee on the carpet, but I noticed that after the murder, the stain had been totally scrubbed away.
Hadn't been scrubbed. No, it's not the stain was... It's not that the stain was scrubbed away. It was moved.
I got it! The stain on the girls' locker room carpet wasn't scrubbed away. In fact, I found it on the boys' locker room carpet.
That's definitely the stain from my protein coffee.
Then, does that mean that the carpets were switched too?
Wait, hang on, they can't see the pictures, can they? Because you don't take pictures. You don't, it's just looking at it. So that's definitely, I suppose, it would work. I'm just gonna let it slide.
Why would anyone do that?
To move the murder scene from one locker room to the other. It's certainly plausible, don't you think?
What?
In other words, in order to completely swap the scene of the crime, the bloodstained poster and carpet were moved along with the dead body. By doing this, the killer was able to change the entire room where the murder took place.
I can certainly follow your reasoning, but why would the carpet bother doing that?
Huh?
Why would they go through all that trouble of switching the scene of the crime?
To change where the crime happened.
An even bigger question. If the murder did take place in the boys' locker room, then how did Chihiro get in the boys' locker room in the first place?
Yeah, I think I can help with this one now. So we just got asked that question. Right, let's look at the truth, but actually let's do it so it's not like this.
To get into the locker rooms, you have to swipe your e-handbook across the card reader device, but Chihiro's handbook should have only allowed her access to the girls' locker room.
But as one condition that was changed.
She had no way to get into the boys' locker room to begin with.
No, she did have a way, and I can tell you what it was.
A metal pipe!
Shut up! I'm telling you, I know how she could have done it.
Magic. Is it right? Could you hear it? Gone into the boys' locker room somehow? Oh, broken e-handbook here.
Is it really possible? Could Chihiro really have gotten into the boys' locker room somehow?
Ah! I got it! She must have packed her e-handbook!
No.
She was the ultimate programmer, after all.
True.
I'm sure that would have been no problem for her.
No, I don't think that's it. She used the thing that was in the main hall.
Huh? What thing?
I'm talking about Leon's handbook, of course.
No, it's wrong. No. I don't think Chihiro used Leon's handbook.
Oh, so we are.
Because Leon's handbook was broken.
Oh. Well, then, yeah, I guess that'd be pretty impossible, huh?
I am struck silent by how quickly you gave up.
Lars, isn't there a regulation against using someone else's handbook?
Not if they're dead.
Actually, the rule states that loaning your handbook is prohibited. It says nothing about borrowing one. In other words, you could borrow a dead person's handbook all you want, and you'd be safe.
Yup, yup, yup! Hit the nail square on the noggin!
Of course, if it were broken, that wouldn't make any sense anyway.
So then, she must have hacked hers, like I said. She used her ultimate programmer skills and...
Psst! You can't fix an e-handbook! The instant you open one up, a security buzzer starts blaring!
So, if she didn't use Leon's handbook, and she didn't modify her own handbook...
Then her original handbook must have allowed her access to the boys.
Maybe Mr. Nyagi's initial assumption is just... wrong?
It seems like there's no way she could have got into the boys' locker room. So I guess so.
Okay then, I vote for Byakuya!
Is that it then? Chira was killed in the girls' locker room and Byakuya's the only one who did it, really? But still, I don't know what Asuka can do.
I agree with you though. I think you're on the right track.
What the... You finally decide to open your mouth and that's what you have to say? There's no way she could get in the boys' locker room, right?
Why are you so sure she couldn't get in? There's still one other way she could have gained access.
What? What are you talking about? What other way is there?
Well, to explain that, why don't we take a little break from the trial? I'd like you all to come see something.
Wait! Just what do you think?
Don't worry. This'll make the whole trial more exciting. I'm sure that thought must please you.
Huh? It'll make things more exciting?
Oh, yay!
All right, then. I declare an official class trial recess!
For real?
Now then, what is it you want to show us? It better not be boring or I'll be very unhappy!
Oh, I have no doubt it'll meet your lofty expectations. So, shall we go?
I like how she plays him. I love her. Oh, that's so good. Just like, you'll have to come see. So before I even knew what was happening, the class trial had been put on hold. We headed off with Kyoko in the lead. And where she took us was... Chihiro's room? No.
The girls' locker room?
We've already searched this place top to bottom! What are you trying to pull, Missy?
I'd like you to examine the victim's body one more time.
You want
to
check
sure
it again?
Be sure to examine the entire body very carefully. Take your time.
Touch the tits!
Examine her carefully? Like, using our hands? No way!
It's probably best if I don't run my hands all over a girl's dead body.
Well...
It's not that I'm creeped out or anything, it's just...
By the way, the reason I said the boob thing is because you find out something interesting.
Very well.
And that just sounds wrong until you know, but...
But you're a girl. You shouldn't have to touch a dead body. Just let one of the boys do it.
No, it's okay. I think Chihiro would rather have a girl examine her. So just leave this to me.
Sakura...
What is this? Some kind of secret girl-on-girl action? Is that what you're
about? That's not it at all. Stop screwing around!
Okay, here I go. I'm sorry, Chihiro. Please excuse the intrusion.
You're not helping her give birth? Here I go. Fuck you now. Putting her hands together in a brief prayer, Sakura then began to quietly examine her body.
I'm sure to check her entire body, and I believe we will solve this particular mystery.
Her entire body? I know you say that, but... What? This is...
A dick!
What is this? What is
oh,
it?
God.
Not possible. It's not possible.
Sakura's eyes were staring wildly at Jira's lifeless form. Her massive frame trembled.
This girl is...
A boy!
Is a boy!
So... She was actually a he.
He's gonna go, ah!
What?
You're joking, right?
I wouldn't joke about this.
Ben.
Super Saiyan!
It's really true?
Chihiro was a guy?
Which means going into the boys' locker room she'd have no problem with.
Oh, what? You guys didn't know? Heck, I knew that right off the bat!
Shihiro Fujisaki was totally a guy!
He was a cross-dresser? Oh, I was really on fire! I wish I had killed him!
So, Yoko wanted to show everyone, huh? Interesting. Yes, that certainly does make things much more exciting. Now let's ride this wave of excitement back to the courtroom and get back to the trial. I do apologize for keeping you waiting. Now then, let's resume the class trial. We've all just learned of the shocking revelation that Chihiro was actually a boy. Let's pick up from there.
Yes, well, I don't know his reason for hiding it, but the fact is, Chihiro was not a girl, but a boy.
To think that Chihiro was actually a guy. The thought never even crossed my mind.
Was male. He would have had no problem gaining access to the boys' locker room.
Assuming his handbook did, in fact, list his gender as male, then yes, that would be true.
Of course his handbook said he was a boy. He dressed like a girl, but he was a boy through and through.
So then, there should be no issue with Makoto's initial assertion. The victim was killed in the boys' locker room, and was then later moved to the girls' locker room. And the killer could have easily used Sayaka or Junko's handbook to get into the girls' locker room.
So Chihiro really was killed in the boys' locker room?
I still don't understand the motive for moving the body, but yes, that does seem plausible.
Probably as a, you know, final justice for her.
I must admit, I did find it rather odd.
We'll also shift the blame
to
another person.
I knew he felt a little off. There was a certain incongruity to his female body.
This is the most titillating situation!
Titillating? Pretty sure you chose that word on purpose.
So now everything has been connected. All the mysteries have finally become clear.
Okay, well, connected or clear or whatever, we still think you're the killer, remember?
Very interesting. This has become very interesting indeed.
Ah, he's off in his own little world.
What about you, Makoto? After everything we've learned, do you still think Byakuya's the killer?
Well, without a doubt, Byakuya's the one that made Chihiro's death look like Genocide Jack did it. But I think he might not actually be the killer after all.
What? But aren't you the one who accused him in the first place?
He just seems to be too easygoing about all this. Like he's enjoying us solving the mystery. The way he's acting, it makes it seem like it doesn't have anything to do with him.
And you think that might be because it doesn't have anything to do with him?
It could
Plus,
be an act.
The evidence he left behind was a little too, how can I put it, overt. He consciously chose to use the extension cord, knowing it could connect him to the murder. At least, that's how I see it. And Byakuya, when you found out the murder took place in the boys' locker room, it seemed to rattle you. And then again, when you found out Chihiro was actually a guy. If you really were the killer, that stuff wouldn't have had any effect on
you. It was called acting,
so
but yeah, okay.
So that's your thinking, huh? Well, it bothers me that you don't have more concrete reasons, but it's fine. I guess I'll mark it as correct for the time being.
Mark it as correct?
He's right. I am not the culprit. I just happened to come across the corpse in the girls' locker room and decided to alter it.
Are you
fucking
with
How
us
did
right
you get
now?
That?
No, I am not effing with you right now.
Yeah, that's a shit. It's like, I'm not going to say fucking, you imbecile.
Well, I find it very hard to believe.
Go ahead. Find it very hard to believe. You're free to be executed along with the rest of us.
I like that he doesn't have to give a shit.
Really
I love her.
Truth, why? Why do you do that to his body?
My reasons hardly matter right now. Uncovering the culprit is much more important, wouldn't you say? Now then, if it wasn't me, who was it?
Well, I don't think I can say for sure without talking about it a little more.
You're seriously gonna keep going? We're all good, aren't we? I thought it was clear Byakuya did it.
No, I'm with Makoto. If there's any doubt whatsoever, we need to explore every possibility. Because if we're wrong, we all die here.
That's true. Very well then. I'm with you too.
Damn straight. Count me in.
Do you not have a mind of your own?
Of course I do. What am I, an ant or something?
Anyway, let's discuss this all as a group one more time. We still have time to make our decision.
That's very true.
Our lives are all on the line.
Excellent. Then shall we resume our game of hide and seek?
If Byakuya didn't do it, then who's the real killer? Who murdered Chihiro? There's one thing that we know about the killer. Killer's a guy. Only a guy could get in there. And it's not me, it's not Byakuya. Since the crime scene was a boys' rock room, you'd need a boys' handbook to get in. Since Leon's handbook is apparently broken, the killer would have had to use her own. In other words, it had to be a guy. But that's still not enough, I need to find some more clues. Celeste account? I'll select Celeste account for
Isn't
now.
Isn't there a single clue that might lead us to who did it?
Well, the clues are one thing, but did nobody get a look at the killer?
I'm sure if someone saw the killer, they would have said something by now.
Perhaps someone saw the victim at some point. Even that might be enough for now.
Yeah. All we need right now is any kind of new info.
It's over. It's all over. You want to know who saw the victim? The killer. And only the killer.
No.
No, it's wrong.
Thank you for being depressed, though, because otherwise I couldn't have put that anywhere.
I believe someone else did see the victim before he was murdered. What do you think, Celeste?
Now that you mention it, yes. I did see him.
Huh? Really?
Oh, but I suppose only Makoto knows about this. The
Makoto.
Rest of you had no idea, did you? That is why you're all making such ugly noises. It was last night, right before nighttime. I saw Chihiro in the dormitory warehouse. I saw him stuffing a track jacket into a duffel bag, and then, I assume, he headed off to exercise.
A track jacket and a duffel bag? But we didn't find anything like that at the murder scene.
Because we didn't look
in
the lockers.
It seems likely that the culprit destroyed them to get rid of any evidence.
And that is when he said something that struck me as rather odd.
Well, I better get going. I'm kind of in a hurry. By the way, that's why I tried to, like... Oh, hi. I'm a guy. Hi. But you could also... Hi, I'm a girl. It works both ways. So, hopefully, I didn't give anything away when I did that voice. But I tried to, like, make it so that it was believable. So, if you say I went, hello, I'm totally a guy, then it'd be a bit odd. But if I went, hey, I'm a woman... Then, yeah, still not believable.
Chihiro told me he was in a hurry. But why would he be in a hurry? Only if someone were waiting for him, I should think.
So, Mr. Fujisaki was on his way to meet with someone, and then they were going to work out together?
But Hina and I had invited him to exercise with us plenty of times, and he always...
But he didn't want the secret to get out.
Because he was afraid you'd find out the secret he was hiding, right?
Which means that conversely, he must have trusted whoever he was meeting with very much enough so that he was willing to risk his secret being revealed.
Hang on, do we have a character bio thing? Report card, yeah. Okay. Right, let's go through the mails. And it's gotta be someone who could have been working out. Right, so we know it's not us. It could have been Kyoko. It could have been Kyo. It could have been Taka. We've just said it's not him. Could have been Mondo. He's dead. No chance it's him. It could have been him. Right, so we're down to three people. So, Taka, Mondo, or Yashiro.
Oh, what a marvelous friendship!
The point is, whoever he met up with is the culprit, right? So we just gotta figure out who it was.
But knowing what we know, I can't even guess.
No,
You already have what you need to make the connection.
Huh?
You know who the killer is.
Seriously? Who is it? Who's the killer?
Think back to the track jacket and duffel bag the killer disposed of. Focus on the details of these items, and it should become obvious who was waiting for him.
Are you sure about that? You really think we can figure out who did it based on two pieces of evidence that we don't have?
What? You want to track down some fingerprints or something?
Even if we had the equipment for that, we wouldn't know how to use it.
As was noted, the evidence is already gone. There's nothing to get fingerprints from.
Maybe, but we can make certain inferences if we just take the time to talk it out.
Easy for you to say, but fine. Celeste.
I'm dumb, is what she just said.
The bag was just a normal duffel bag from the warehouse. All the bags in there are the same, so I can't imagine what would make that one special.
Well, if I remember right, there was a decent variety of tracksuits to choose from. Do you think there might be some connection between the culprit and Chihiro's jacket?
Also, this is unrelated, but that's probably why Chihiro wanted to get stronger. Because she wanted to be more boyish, probably.
Let's explore that and talk a bit more about the jacket he took.
Does Chihiro's track jacket really hold some clue about the killer? Somehow it's really hard to believe. I have no idea about this one. We'll try Celeste, but we probably have to pick one up.
First of all, we know where Chihiro was heading. He was on his way to go exercise. Mm-hmm. So next we have to ask, why did he choose the specific tracksuit that he did?
What do you mean, the specific tracksuit?
I got it! He picked that tracksuit because it matched the one the culprit was wearing!
So, what you're saying is, the killer was wearing the same blue tracksuit as him? My tracksuit is black!
I don't even have a tracksuit! Cause exercising sucks!
I have a white tracksuit, personally. I got it from the warehouse, if you must know.
Did any of that really help us get any closer to figuring out who the culprit is?
No way. Not a chance.
You heard him, right?
What?
What he just said without even realizing it?
Yeah. I know.
First of all, we know where Chihiro was headed.
Right, let's just
he was
try
on
that.
His way to go exercise.
So next thing, why did he choose?
What do you mean this?
I got it! It matched the one that...
So, what you're saying? The killer was wearing the same blue tracksuit.
No,
didn't know it was blue, motherfucker! Well, I thought that was odd, but I didn't know where to put it.